Hello and welcome to 25 professional titles for Blender. It is compatible with nearly all Blender versions. No plugins are required as this is done entirely in Blender. There is a PDF tutorial if you do not want to watch the video. Alright, let's check out our product. The first thing we are going to talk about is background image. The background image is licensed CCO, which means Creative Commons Zero, which means it is in public domain. Public domain means you can use it for whatever you want, commercial purposes, non-commercial purposes, you can even sell it if you want. So what I have done is I have taken this photo from pixels and I have blurred it using the Blender Compositor. You can see that I have blurred it in 3 resolutions and I will tell you why later on. I have told you earlier that this supports 4K as this photo itself is around 6K by 4K. Then we have fonts. In fonts we have 4 types of fonts. I have to clarify here that these fonts are available under Apache license and OpenSIL license, which means that I can sell them in a package as long as I tell you that they are of this license and you can use them for commercial or non-commercial purposes. 4 fonts: Clear Sans. Clear Sans is made by Intel if I recall correctly. Open Sans, which is I think made by Google, I am not really sure. Oswald and Railway. In Help, we have 2 folders, PDF Help and Video Tutorial. What you are seeing right now is going to be up in Video Tutorial, while PDF Help has the PDF. Let's open up the PDF. As you can see, there are total of 19 pages. In the index, you can click on any of the title and it will take you to that section. Clicking on the bottom, Professional Titles for Blender, will take you back to the titles. And the rest is basic stuff. What I am going to tell you right now is going to be here too. So if you do not want to watch this video or just want to jump right on, you can check out this PDF file. In the scene number, each scene is noted by a letter and a number, such as the professional titles type animation is under A1 and the rest of it are A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8, A9, B1, B2, B3. So basically when you go into the Blender as we are going to now, you can see them and you can check them however you want. And if you like something, just go to the specific scene number and it will take you to that place. Now the music. The thing about music is that it is also licensed Creative Commons Zero. I have added this to screenshots for proof. You can use this music for whatever way you want, commercial or non-commercial use. All thanks to vova.me. After that, this particle animation. This particle animation is rendered by me. There are total of 240 frames. So at around 24 FPS, it is going to be around 10 seconds. Apart from that, then there are sound effects. These 2 sound effects have been taken from Open Game Art. These are pretty good sound effects. I have added these sound effects as we will see in the title. And here comes the trailer. Here is the poster. Now let's jump into the titles. It is called titles.blend. Let's open it. As you can see right above here in the scene section, if you click on the arrow, you can check that each one is named by a letter and a number. There are total of 25, so it's around C7. So go into the whatever title you want. You can check on rendered to see how it's going to look. By default CPU is enabled, but if you have a Nvidia GPU card, you can use it. Just change this from CPU to GPU. And below here in the performance section in the render type, just change this from 16x16 to 256x256. You're all set. If you want to just check how an animation is going to look, just click on render image. You will get a pretty good idea on how the final animation is going to look. We will go into the compositor soon, but this is just to give you a basic idea. Let's say you just want to get started. You are not interested in complicated details. You just want to create a title scene as smoothly and as speedily as possible. So here we go. You just go into the tab. We see how it looks. I will change this to GPU as I want this to render quickly. As you can see, everything here is adjusted. And if you look at the video editing section, I have also added the sound effects, but you can change it to whatever you want. Remember to change the scene here too, as Blender doesn't remember when switching from one mode to another. As you can see, apart from here, now we we will just see the text, we will change it to whatever we want, and we will click on render animation. The animation will be rendered and will be saved as an video file in the rendered folder under this name, rendered ../. Now let's go to the compositor. In the compositor, you can see each node is color coded and each node has a specific explanation. So if you are a beginner or if you don't realize what's going on, you can just read it. In the node groups, you can click tab and it opens up even more nodes with color coded and with explanation too. Basically, these four nodes are going to be there in every scene. The first one is the render layer, that is the text which we see here. The second one is the background image or the pixels image we had seen earlier. The third one is a particle animation. The particle animation is at 50% strength, as 100% strength looks overpowers the background image and does not look nice in my opinion. But you can change it if you want. You just go on here at strength and change the value to whatever you want. Just render an image once and then change it so that you can see at what values does this change. There is a vignette. Vignette means that the corners get dark so that your eyes are focused in the middle. These two can be adjusted. Currently the rate is at 70%, that is 0.7. You can change it to whatever you want. I think 0.7 is the correct one, but if you want, you can change it. If you want to see the node setup, you can just click tab. You can see that each one has a explanation. And after that, we will just go into one and just click on render. Hang on, let me just enable GPU so that I can do this faster. Alright, now let's click on render image. Here you can see the render layer is the text. I hope you can see that. I'm going to zoom in. It's just the text without any background. So if I click on M here on background image, the background is going to be hidden. So this adds background. This adds the particle animation. You see all those floating particles. So if I click on M here, you can see that they disappear. And as I've said earlier, I can toggle the values as I want. So let's say I want 100% strength. So let's click on strength and press 1 and click enter. Now these are at 100%. I personally think they overpower the front text and hence I don't like it. I will tune it back to 0.5. And here's the vignette. The vignette means the corners get dark so that your eyes are focused in the middle. Let's click on mute so we can see how vignette works. I hope you can see in the final recording, but the corners are a little dark. But if I click M, all of these are of the same strength and looks bright. I personally like the vignette, so I'm going to keep it in. So apart from them, now as I've shown you here, as you can see in compositing, almost everything has explanation. The one thing people may notice is that in title A6 and A7, there is nothing but black, and you might wondering what's going on. See, this is achieved by mixing two layers. So what here happened is that whatever is happening is they are showing all the layers at once, as you can see here. So this may seem a little odd, but if you want to just check out on how it is going to look, just click on render image. Each scene has its device set at CPU. You will have to change it at GPU. Change it to 256 by 256. All right, now let's click on render image, and you will see that this is the first layer having the first text, then the second layer will have the second text, and the third layer will have the orange ribbons, and by adding these three text together we get the final result. The final result is then added to the background image, and then we get the final image. So do not worry, this happens, if I recall correctly, at A6, at A7, at A9 and at C1. This does work, but due to the mixing of layers, this looks a little bit odd. But it works. You can check it out if you want. Let's move on to the right hand side, and we can see the certain things around here. We can see it is at 1080p. I will show you how to change it at 4K or 720p. Here it is already, all the codecs are added. Each animation has a length of 144 frames, that is around 6 seconds. It takes 2 seconds for the animation to complete, 2 seconds it is hold, and the rest of the 2 seconds it goes back. All 25 titles have a running time of 6 seconds, that is 144 frames. One more thing I forgot to tell you is that this can also be used as lower thirds. What lower thirds means is that You often have seen those documentaries where the person is talking and on the corner you see his name and his designation. That is called lower thirds, basically to provide information at the lower third of the screen. So instead of just moving the camera, so let's go into the scene tab. It is the third tab. After that, we will check into the camera. It says camera B1. B1 is the name of the scene. If you want to activate the lower third camera, you just need to click on this and go right down to B1 LT. LT stands for lower thirds. There you go. The animation now works just as we want. Let us change camera back to what we had. One more thing is that this the text does not have a location keyframe. So if you think that your text is too small or too large, and if you want to resize it or reposition it, you can do that. You just need to edit it. Let's see. Alright. And let's say I do not like the way this looks. I think it's too bold. The text is too bold and it's too large. I want to reduce the size a little bit. So I will click on S. I will reposition it using G and Y. I will do the same with the bottom one. And there we go. The rest will work as intended. You do not have to do anything different. Or as it only contains the necessary keyframes required for animation, you can pretty much get away with most of the stuff here. I hope you have a basic understanding of Blender, though I will help you in whatever way I can. If you have any problem with my product, you can contact me at jugaadanimation@gmail.com. Now let's jump to a different scene. I will now show you how to render in 4K. So first of all, you will need to change the resolution to 4K. 4K is 3840 by 2160, but if you just try to render this, it will not come out good. Anyways, let's click on render. The problem is that while the text is at 4K, the background image and the particle animation is still at 1080p, so it will appear wrong. A small square of background image can be seen and the rest will be rendered as transparent. Here you can see that it does not work as the way we want. So we will go to the compositing section and we will change this. Here is our scene. Here is our problem. So we will go into the background image tab and we will open the 4K version of our image, background image. So here's BG4K. There is also 720p and 1080p. That's why I said in a trailer it has support up to 4K. So here's 4K. You can render any custom resolution, save it as an image and then use the same technique as above. Now we can see that the background image has fit, but the particles are still in the small square. We want the particle to fill the whole section. Alright, so now we will do the same with the particle section. We will click on tab here. We will go to the particle animation. We will click on here open and we will click on up. This says 2K, which means it is at 1080p resolution. We want 4K. So at 4K, we will click A. This will select all the images. You do not need to do anything else. You just need to click A and click open image. Everything will be set by Blender. And now you can see that it works. Pretty much it is as simple as it can get. Material nodes such as, hang on, let me change it. The material nodes, as you can see that, also are color coded. And wherever any complex things are done, you can see that there is an explanation on how that is achieved. Colors. Let's say that you want red color on the ribbon instead of orange on the blue background because it looks good. You just click on the ribbon which has the color, then you go into the material tab. Here you can select the color whatever you want. Let's say I want red color, so I will reduce the green value and reduce the blue value, and here I have the red color. I can just click on render image to see how it's going to look. Changing font. I have showed you earlier that there are 4 fonts in this section. If you want to change the font, you need to select the text using right click. Then you need to go to the font tab. And here in the regular section, you need to click on the folder icon and load any new font you want. Let's say I want a Clear Sans thin font. I am pretty satisfied with this. Or if you want, you can replace that with Oswald. Or let's say I want a railway thin font. Let me just scale this a little. As I've told you, it only has the keyframes it needs and not that it doesn't need. So this helps pretty much every time. One more thing I forgot to tell you, that this camera itself does not have a keyframe. So if you think this looks too small or too large, you can just click G so that the camera moves, then click the middle mouse button so that the camera zooms towards and away from the object. You can just select whatever you want and it will work because the camera doesn't have a keyframe. Let's say you want to render it as lower third. Let's say you do not want the background image to load. So first we will have to change the file format from video to images. So we will change this to from FFmpeg to PNG, and we will change this to RGB to RGBA so that alpha is rendered. If alpha is not rendered, it will be rendered as a black image, and that does not work right. So apart from that, what you will need to do is you need to go to the compositing tab and go to your scene, and here we will select the render layer directly to the composite. There you can see that it is rendered as transparent and it has nothing else. The final thing you can do to quicken render time is that as you are not going to render the background, you can just use box select, that is Ctrl B, and only render a specific part of the animation, that is where the animation is going to be. This will speed up render time and your animation will be rendered as quickly as possible. If you want to get out of the box select, you have to click Ctrl Alt and B. Adding audio, you just click on video editing, you can see all of this and you can even hear all of this because the audio scrubbing is on. You can click on play so that you hear how the sound effects sound. Let's say you do not like the sound effects and you want to add another one. So what you are going to do, you will first need to click Shift A. This will open up a menu. After that you will need to select sound. You can click on whatever sound effect you want. There are total of 16 sound effects. Let's say I want a sword sound. By using your scroll wheel you can zoom, and let's scroll down here on the right hand side and check draw waveform. So you can see at where the audio is, and wherever you see the animation making an impact, you put the audio there. Let's say you want to change the length of the animation. Let's say you are not interested in 6 seconds. So what you will need to do is you will need to drag another viewport. Anyways, we will click here and go to dope sheet. Here you can see that there is a big gap between two frames. So this is the start and this is the end, simply put. So let's say you want to stretch it to 4 seconds or you want to stretch it to 8 seconds. So 8 seconds is 24 into 8, that is 192 frames. So you will go to 192 frames. You will change the end from 144 to 192 frames and you will click the other half. You do not want to touch the first half because the first half setups the animation and holds it. You select all the other keyframes of the other half, then you click G and X, or you just click G and you keep your cursor to the end of your animation, that is 192nd frame, and then you zoom in and you make sure that the end of your keyframe matches the end of your cursor. There, now the animation lasts 8 seconds instead of the usual 6. That's around it. 25 professional titles for Blender is available at Blender Market. You can also go to my website at jugaadanimation.com if you have any problem. If you have any problem, you can contact me at jugaadanimation@gmail.com. I hope you have benefited from it. I also create Blender tutorials at infographic tutorials at my website. You may go to jugaadanimation.com/blog for it. I would love to create more tutorials, and let me know if there is a demand for motion graphics tutorials. I would love to make motion graphics tutorial as I do not see a lot of them here. Thank you.